it's just got a really cool sound and vibe to it, and it's an amazing space and in a beautiful part of the world, and the gear's great, and it's just a cool place to come and hang and make music.
I'm Paul Stacey. I'm producing Scott McKeon's album in a very professional way.
We lost the CMV, so we need to get a...
I think if you know what you're doing, you can make the best of what a room offers. I mean, it's always down to the room and how everything sounds in the room. Trying to find the right place to put the drums, the right place to put the guitars and stuff, and then trying to get them to gel together.
Well, the album was pretty much jams that we pieced together, and now that they're pieced together, we're kind of recreating them and videoing them. So it's the first time we've played them since we recorded them, which is a couple of years ago.
We just end up doing this record because we've been playing together on and off, and he found out that I produce records, so he asked me to produce his record, and then this today is to sort of kind of get more insight into how the record was done, even though we're doing it, you know, in another room and it's different, but gives us a chance to have another shot at doing four tracks, you know. So. And here he is, Scotty McKeon.
Thank you.
Well, they're some of my favourite musicians, to be honest. Jeremy and Paul. Paul's mostly been producing and mixing the album. But the whole idea was working with them was to capture what everyone does best, really, all in the same room, like nothing added, nothing edited, just capturing what we all do and having fun doing it. They have an old school approach to music. They kind of remind me of what musicians, when you read about people like in the 60s and 70s, I think Jeremy and Paul have that in their DNA, you know, old jazz musicians, old rock musicians, where they're kind of, they don't suffer fools. They're not polite. They're not very nice people. They're kind of like just, and they play music like that. It's life or death for them. Rocco Palladino is an amazing bass player. It runs in his blood, really, playing the bass, I think. He's kind of got an amazing touch. Like, he's just got this tone when he plays, when he hits the strings, which is just this big sound. So yeah, this, and his timing is incredible. So it just inspires me to play better when I play with these people. Ross Stanley is, an amazing Hammond player, keys player, and jazz musician, and his knowledge of music is pretty incredible. So yeah, it's nice having that jazz element with the kind of rootsy, bluesy stuff, because a lot of what I do is kind of quite bluesy. So having the kind of jazz thing somewhere in there really brings out another side of, side of my playing. Well, Gavin is like, I heard someone say it recently, he's like all your favourite singers mixed into one. So I can hear like Paul Rodgers and like Terence Trent D'Arby and James Brown and Michael Jackson when he sings. He just gets inside the music and he loves just vibing off everyone. So again, like, you know, we recorded all the vocals with Gav, with him in the room. And those are just like the first takes. There's no fixing or anything. But yeah, Gav's, I think, one of the coolest vocalists there is.
This band is insane. It's an absolute pleasure to be playing with this band. It's, for me, one of the best in the UK, if not the world. It's got everything that a band should have, including problems and issues. we have a really nice relationship, so we just kind of bounce between each other. So Scott starts the tune. I just kind of find where he isn't going, and fit the spaces.
Not normally what you tend to do when you film something to promote an album. You usually replay the album in a similar way, but it will be similar. But we're not thinking about it. We know enough about playing to be able to sit down and just play. And you know, it's like if you were driving a car and you've got to turn right because that's the way you've got to go. It's the same with music. It's like you get a signpost by what other people are playing, and you can turn right, you can turn left, you can do what you like. I mean, in this environment, we're just going to do takes until we've got something we like, but I think most of the album is first or second take. I don't think we did anything more than two takes.
Thank you. Paul Stacey that asked me to come along and play on the album. And it was a lot of fun, mainly because it's not really like anything I'd done for a long time. I normally have a lot of rehearsal and stuff, and on this particular session, Paul literally just, we set up the Hammond in the studio and he was like, right, go and play. And that was, those were the takes. It's quite an eclectic mix really, but I guess it's sort of leaning heavily towards blues rock, I suppose. But there's definite jazz elements in there. All sorts really. I mean, I guess my favourite part of it is that we have the freedom just to sort of do what we like, you know.
Yeah.
he's obviously a really authentic blues player, which is, I mean, he's got so many things together that, I mean, a lot of blues is to do with sort of like, you know, everybody does, a lot of people just follow B.B. King, and then obviously people follow Stevie Ray Vaughan and obviously John Mayer, and I don't know. But the blues thing is, he goes into all the history of it, and he's got a very authentic thing. He's the rhythm part, which is really important. Obviously he can, you know, tear it up as well, but he's done a lot of work on checking out all the rhythm playing from the sort of like the earlier than the 60s and the, so like the 50s and the Chuck Berry's and the, but also the God, you got me now.
Baby, I'm
The songs are kind of chosen because they kind of just show different sides of like my personality and the kind of music that I'm into.